after a horrible 1995. Lost on points to Mike Devaney and Peter Harris. Hasn't fought since April of last year. And really, although he's only 27, difficult to see where he can go if he loses tonight against Wenton. I'm sure he will have other ideas, though. If he can't be up for a British title fight, you've really got no business being in this game.
He's a good fighter, Dave.
He's a good fighter.
He and his brother Drew are very good. Very nice guys, too.
And we await the arrival of the Super Bantamweight Champion of Great Britain, the first ever Super Bantamweight Champion of Great Britain. There's some of the fans who made the trek down from Liverpool. And there is the Lonsdale belt, worn bandolier fashion, around Richie Wenton's chest.
Good, exciting fighter, Richie Wenton. Pleasure to watch this guy. He's really, really thrills the crowd.
So, both boys in the ring, let's get it on with that one.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the main attraction of the evening here at Basildon's Festival Hall, provided by Barry Hearn for Matchroom Boxing, sponsored by Acclaim Entertainments, and this is a super bantamweight contest with a match made in 8 stone 10 pounds over 12 rounds each of 3 minutes duration for the British Super Bantamweight title. Your British Boxing Board of Control steward in charge, Dr. Ozzy Ross, your area representative, John Handelar, your timekeeper, Nick White, and when the bell rings and the action begins, the man in charge is Richie Davis of London. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting and introducing to you the boxers. First, in the red corner with the red tartan shorts. 7 wins from 10 contests, 4 inside the distance. And today he weighed in at 8 stone 8 pound 12 ounces. He comes into the ring as the former Pentacontinental Featherweight Champion and challenger for the title from Scotland, Wilson Docherty. And ladies and gentlemen, across that ring in the red, white and blue shorts is a man with 19 wins from 22 contests, 8 inside the distance, weighing in at 8 stone 9 pound 10 ounces. He comes from Liverpool. He is the reigning WBO Intercontinental and British Super Bantamweight Champion, making the second defense of his title. Ladies and gentlemen, Richie Wenton. Ladies and gentlemen, 12 3-minute rounds of boxing.
We both obey your instructions in the dressing room. Defend yourselves at all times and obey my commands at all times. Shake hands now. Good luck to you.
So, the scene is set for this title defence main event of the evening here on Pro Box. David Brennan, Nicky Piper for you all over the world at ringside here on Pro Box. This is round one. Wenton in the white and Docherty, what would you expect? The tartan. And first telling shot in from Wenton, who is not the world's biggest puncher. Just overwhelmed Paul Lloyd in that Pro Box fight that we saw up in Chester last year, coming off a defeat in a European title challenge against Vincenzo Belcastro in October. Gallant effort, lost on points. Had trouble with a very, very fussy referee that night, but such is life in Italy.
Well, I think Wendon's punching power has improved, actually. He's better than his record on paper suggests. He's a bigger puncher than that. And he does like to get the job done early, so this could be interesting. Docherty, however, is a very confident pro.
New face in the Wenton corner tonight. He's got Glyn Rhodes, the old Sheffield welterweight. Canny character. Very underrated fighter, good fighter. saw him give a lot of people a lot of trouble on Pro Box, and nice to know he hasn't been lost to the game. And this is a good start from Wenton. And he's already wobbled Docherty a couple of times. Docherty with brave heart on the waistband of his tartan trunks. Richie Davis, referee for this contest. One of the newest star class referees in this country.
Good right cross from Wenton.
This was a terrific start by the champion. Good, positive, authoritative performance so far in round one. And Docherty not to settle into any sort of rhythm at all. Hasn't been allowed to.
Well, he's working just as hard as the champion, but Wenton is getting through with the better shots. Seems to be that right hand of Wenton that at the moment is the telling shot.
Come on, whoa. They are, of course, fighting at championship weights. Wenton looks physically so much bigger and stronger than Docherty.
Yes, he's taller and has a longer reach, very big shoulders.
For the champion. Quick reminder, we're fighting under British rules. Only the referee scores 10 points to the winner of a round, 9.5 to the loser, 9 if there's a knockdown. And there is Richard Davis scoring round one. And I don't think there could be too many doubts that round has gone into Wenton's column. Over in the Wenton corner, you can see Richard Davis, Glyn Rhodes rather, there he is in the red t-shirt. So, a good positive start from the champion. Now he must capitalize on that.
Second out, round two.
As out they come for the second. Wenton in the white. Docherty from Condorrett in Scotland, which is roughly midway between Glasgow and Edinburgh. He's in the tartan.
Well, on my card, that was a 10-9.5 round for Wenton. Ridiculous way of scoring, isn't it, really?
Crazy.
I think it's just the British Boxing World Control showing off, trying to make out their referees are more intelligent than the other referees in the world, because they can add up. Fools me sometimes, and I'm supposed to be a member of Mensa.
It does seem very archaic, doesn't it, that we still have the half point system. Mark, you, we ought to be lucky they don't still score in quarter points, which they used to.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Keep the blows up, son.
Well, you're showing an age now, Dave.
Curses.
Good left uppercut, right cross from Wenton. Picking his shots well. He's thinking and he's rolling and he's making Docherty miss.
You can probably see a few faces over the other side of the ring. We're sort of evenly split. We've got the Scottish camp with Tommy Gilmore. We've got Drew Docherty at ringside as well, Wilson's brother. Drew Docherty, of course, British bantamweight champion. Yeah, lovely jab. Speared through Docherty's guard.
He's not letting go with too much power at the moment, but he's picking the shots well. Nice stiff shots.
looking a little more compact and composed in this round, but Wenton's still making him miss. Good right counter from Wenton, just clipping Docherty as he came in. There's not quite the passion, well, there couldn't be really, of the atmosphere on the night before Paul Lloyd in Chester. I mean, that was really something very special, and it certainly inspired Wenton. Well, the crowd, the boys from Liverpool, are doing their job fairly adequately.
Yeah, these are good shots. He's throwing lovely combinations, leading with a left uppercut. Right hand, yeah. And left hooks. He's really throwing everything.
I think what's impressive, Nicky, he's making every shot count.
Yes, not wasting a thing tonight. He's really concentrating, he's looking at Docherty, seeing what he's doing, and then countering with superb combinations. He's employing the... Well, this is the end of the round. We'll see him pick some great combinations here. Right hand through the guard. Why Docherty was complaining, I don't know. And then landed it straight away again. Not a good start from Doherty's point of view.
Seconds out. Round
Tommy
three.
Gilmore, Barry Hearn, Drew Docherty in between the two of them. Round three. Really starting to unload now against Docherty, and is really looking very, very impressive. He's waving Docherty onto him, stand and fight, he's saying. Well, from Docherty's viewpoint, that is not the best battle plan.
He's really throwing shots from every angle, though. And that's what's confusing Docherty. He's landing so cleanly. He's employing what they call a screw shot very well. He's leaning over to the left and twisting the fist as he goes through his guard. Goes through Docherty's guard is Wenton.
Well, this is so far, and let's not forget this is a 12 rounder and it's early days, but this is a mighty impressive performance so far from the champion. And quite simply, Docherty has not been allowed to settle. There's an almost radar-like accuracy about every shot that Wenton throws. And Docherty's coming back with a fair amount in reply, but he's simply not landing. Because in addition to punching so well, Wenton is slipping so many shots beautifully too.
Yes. I mean, Docherty's obviously landed a few this round. Nothing of any note. There we see Wenton. Perfectly planting his feet, balance is good, and he's concentrating and watching everything Docherty does. Again, that screw shot, the left uppercut.
One thing Wenton, about the only thing he must guard against at the moment, is getting overconfident.
Well, Docherty is a very fit man, and he can do 12 rounds, no problem. Whereas Wenton, in a few of his fights, has deteriorated as the fight's gone on. He's got a little tired, and that could be in Doherty's favour during this fight, if Docherty can stay with him through the first half. Good left hook from Docherty that time, and again. Oh, and a right cross from Docherty too.
Not having any noticeable effect. A better round for Docherty, but not good enough to win the round on my card.
Yeah, keep forcing it, son. Look behind the jab, force him back with the jab.
Mine neither.
Let your punches go. Let them flow. Let the punches go inside.
This was the end of the round again. This was the early in the round, sorry, where Wenton was piling on the pressure and getting through with very good shots from every angle. Right hooks, left uppercuts and right crosses. Very, very good. But as you just heard, the corner of Wilson Docherty telling him to get in close and let the punches flow. And that's what he did towards the end of the round and got a bit more success. Again, it was Wenton's round.
Seconds out, round four.
So the fourth round of what has really been a cracking title fight. Remember, at stake is Nigel Wenton's British super bantamweight title, which he won against Bradley Stone, successfully defended against Paul Lloyd. And under the rules of the British Boxing Board of Control, a win tonight, and that Lonsdale belt is his to keep forever. Wilson Docherty has other ideas, though. Chasing a will-o'-the-wisp at the moment. Docherty trying to catch up with Wenton.
Well, again, as you say, the better work coming from Wenton at the beginning of this round. It'll be interesting to see how Docherty fares in the last, say, 30 seconds of this round. It'll give an indication as to whether Wenton is slowing a little bit. He's certainly getting the better of it so far.
Well, he's settled into a groove now as Wenton, and it's up to Docherty to try and disrupt that rhythm. And he's been partially successful. He's certainly coming into this fight a lot more than he was in the first couple of rounds, but not yet enough to cause Wenton any great problems.
Good right hand from Wenton. Still picking the shots well.
What's the shoulder, Wenton?
As the referee is saying to him, he's warning him to the shoulder. He was holding a little too.
And the Scottish contingent in the crowd at ringside looking just a little glum at the moment. Not really surprising. And gazing right into Wenton's eyes, with his face under me there, so focused. At the moment, his entire world is bound by this ring. Just simply unaware of anything that's going on outside.
Well, here we see the last 20 seconds. Let's see how Docherty fares this 20 seconds.
Still a nice poise and balance about Wenton, though.
Yep. His round again, I feel.
Very much so. I certainly haven't seen Wenton box as well as this, and I think a lot of the credit has to go with Glenn Rhodes for this. He's a newish face in the Docherty in the Wenton corner, and he's obviously making his presence felt. See Glenn Rhodes in the red, former Brendan Ingle fighter. And we saw him fight Eamon Loughran once, I think, on Pro Box. And we took Loughran the trip, and he used to take most people the trip. And could whack a few too when he felt in the mood.
10 seconds.
I think by his own admission, never perhaps quite trained hard enough.
Seconds out. Round five.
Challenger's corner a little slow to clear as they come out for round five. It's getting to be a case, and if you're looking at your scorecard and seeing Wenton taking every round and starting to ask yourself, well, is it really as one-sided as we think it is?
Well, yes, of course, if he takes the next two, that's the first 6-2 him, and very, very difficult for Docherty to come back into it. Docherty's not really a big puncher. His eyes are starting to swell a little, especially the right hand, you've got a bit of a mouse. The right eye, I should say, a little bit of a mouse starting to come there.
But when you get to this class of championship boxing, it's so hard, isn't it, to play catch-up once you've let your opponent get 2-3 rounds ahead.
Yes, it is. Lands a good right, which Wenton pretended didn't hurt. I wouldn't like to take it, even from a super bantamweight. And brother Drew Docherty from the side of the ring is getting excited. He feels that his young brother's coming into this more now.
Showing a little bit more aggression and a little bit more fire in this round. A little bit of showboating from the champion.
Yes, he's getting through his Docherty this round.
Hence probably the showboating.
Yes, exactly. I do feel that Wenton is tiring.
Yeah, just when you thought, well, hello, this could be the first round that Docherty's taking. A good combination from the champion, sends the challenger back on his heels. Oh, was that a good left? Oh, what a good shot that was. Takes a decent shot, though, does Docherty.
Wenton working hard to stay ahead in this round. I think he's still edging the round. Good work over the last 30 seconds.
Well, I think that this round has illustrated that Wenton probably still has plenty in the tank. He started the round trying to coast it, and Docherty really came onto him quite strongly, and Wenton responded to the danger and has certainly put together some good shots in the latter half of the round, and once again takes that round on my card.
Yeah, and on mine. However, I would say he did fight back hard, but he put a lot of effort into keeping Docherty under, keeping Docherty down, I should say. I feel Docherty is coming back into this fight. Some good work again. Right hand from Docherty. And a left hook just cupped Wenton. But it was a much closer round. And this is where Wenton came back. Good left hook there. Took it well, though, did Docherty.
10 seconds. Seconds out. Round six.
Round six. And Docherty on my card, and I suspect on Richie Davis' card, is some way behind now. I've given every one of the five rounds completed to the champion in the white, Richie Wenton. But there are signs that Docherty could still salvage something. He simply got to work harder, got to come forward more, got to start throwing more shots. We've said so many times on Pro Box, you've got to go and take the title away from the champion. You're not going to get any favours. You've got to go out and demonstrably win. You've got to be the governor, and that's not happening just yet.
No, however, he's starting this round well. He's got through with a couple of left hooks, which, although haven't landed flush, they've landed.
We've already heard the corner saying to Docherty, getting close, let the punches flow. Well, that's just about sums it up. It's not happening.
Again, Wenton. Docherty through with a good right hand.
Just momentarily switching to southpaw. Confidence from Wenton. Switch hitting.
Yeah, there's no doubt who the superior tactician is here tonight. Wenton is by far the better boxer. Just how long he can keep it up for. That's the question tonight.
Well, I think so far, and let us not forget, still not at the halfway stage, not quite. I think Wenton so far has fought absolutely superbly.
Yes, boxed very well.
Good right uppercut. And that, again, the right came through. And just momentarily, the Scot back on his heels. Coming back bravely, though. Wenton, if ever you wanted to see a fighter jab and move, you've got to look no further than Wenton. Absolute copybook stuff, this. Wenton absolutely unmarked, and Docherty, in comparison, starting to look a little lumpy and bumpy around the face now.
Well, I actually give probably an even round. Much closer that round.
He's tired. I know he's tired.
Fucking tired.
We know he's tired. We're telling you he's tired. Just listen to me getting tired.
Move your head. You've got to go on side to side, Wilson.
Again, a good attack from Wenton. Good uppercuts. It seems that Docherty has no answer to the right and left uppercuts through the middle. Scotch corner telling their man that he's very, very tired.
Seconds out, round seven.
Well, into the second half of the fight now, round seven, and you may have caught a glimpse and heard some snatches from the Docherty corner. Things starting to get a little bit frantic in that corner. Just trying to G Docherty up to just simply do a little bit more. He's trying his best. But Wenton, such an elusive target, such a good counter-puncher. And you have to say, Nicky, that Docherty almost tailor-made for the sort of stylist that Wenton is.
Yes, he is, no doubt. He's, through the first half of the fight, he's eaten up almost everything Wenton's thrown. However, signs are that he's getting back into the fight. I think too late, he has to stop Wenton now to win it. He's certainly not going to win the last six rounds. He's probably going to win a couple of them, maybe more of the rounds than Wenton, but Wenton should be enough, do enough to do to win on punch now. Great right hand from Wenton.
And Wendland starting to mix his shots up now, throwing the occasional uppercut. Working well to head and body. As I say, I haven't seen him fight any better than this. And really, to put the seal on it, would be to stop Docherty, and that's not entirely impossible.
Oh, good shots. So there's other cuts that Docherty has no answer to. Went in pot-shotting, really.
Well, never has a fighter lived more up to a nickname. Braveheart on Docherty's trunks, and Braveheart describes absolutely perfectly how he's fighting, but he's being absolutely outclassed here. And indeed, I suspect there are quite a number of other fighters in this division who would have suffered a similar fate in the mood that Wenton's in tonight.
Beautifully, isn't it?
It's as near flawless as makes no difference, and your heart really goes out with Docherty, who was giving it absolutely everything, but everything on this occasion simply isn't enough.
This was a great right hand from Richie Wenton during that last round. Oh, and Docherty took it so well. Wenton not the biggest of punches, but that must have took some standing up to.
Seconds out, round eight.
Well, five rounds to go now, and this must be one of the easiest fights for Wenton's corner that they can have ever had. Just more of the same. No need to tell him anything, really. Just wind him up in the one-minute break, send him out to fight again. Because I can't really see, Nicky, that anything that he should be doing that he isn't doing at the moment.
No, he's boxing to perfection. More of the same, that's all the corner can say. Again, that right hand getting through. A little jolt to the legs of Docherty.
It was a decent shot from Docherty.
Wenton was going away from it at the time, though.
Raises a little glimmer of hope amongst the Scots in the crowd. But really, single shots are not enough. And it's perhaps quite a lesson for young Spencer Oliver sitting at ringside. These are the heights that he has to aspire to. These two get to the heights that Richie Wenton has reached tonight. And so far, Wenton, despite the fact that he was now with a good right hand, so far is answering quite adequately any fears about his stamina. Still moving very well.
Well, yes, I take it back. I thought he was tiring after four or five rounds, and he's, if anything, got better, as Wenton showed great fitness. He's moved well, he's counted well, and shown great speed and balance. However, there's 4.5 rounds to go, and it's not over yet, Dave.
Well, confident enough and chipper enough that Wenton to talk to him, didn't catch what he said, but I don't think it would have been an invitation for a quick final pint after the fight at this stage anyway.
Champion. obviously supporters of the champion, Richie Wenton. Oh, is this, is that Wenton or Wilson?
That's Wenton.
Great right hand counter over the top of the left lead from Docherty. Wenton threw a great punch there.
Referee breaks you, you'd be first time. Step right away. You break yourself and step back in again and unload. We need all rounds to win a title.
Really cool. Get the punches up quicker.
Let's go, Wilson.
Go on, right hand. Go on, right.
Seconds out. Round 9.
Well, I'm sure you heard the Docherty corner saying 4 more rounds to win the title. And that just about sums it up. He has to stop Wenton. There is no earthly way that he can win this on points.
Well, the corner was suggesting he could, saying if he won the last 4, he would. But I think he needs another 8 rounds to overhaul Wenton. He's that far behind.
Yeah, if they were still fighting 15, he might be in with a shout, but not 12. You know how we could tell those supporters of Wenton were Wentons?
How?
They were waving the Union Jack.
Oh, right.
Because they burned that up in Scotland.
Oh, dear.
Round 9. Wenton, the champion, in the white. Docherty, the challenger, in the tartan. And Docherty somehow has got to find some sort of stoppage punch. Not beyond him, he's stopped a fair few. Of his 7 wins, 4 have been inside the distance, but I don't think even his greatest fans would say he's a one-punch specialist. And I'd suggest that if anybody was going to stop anybody, it would be Wenton would be stopping Wilson.
Yeah, he's landed the bigger shots and the cleaner shots throughout the first 8 rounds.
Well, I think, really, Docherty's simply got to go for broke. He's if he gets stopped, fair enough, he gets stopped. He's a mile behind on points anyway. He's got to try, perhaps, throw caution to the winds, just go in guns firing, maybe. One or two little things he's tried out in the gym, not entirely happy with. Well, try them now, see if they come off. You never know. Could be a hero. Almost for the first time, he succeeds in backing Wenton up against the ropes.
I think Wenton went of his own accord, though. Tremendous hard, Docherty's showing, but it's not quite enough so far.
Well, hard will get you so far, won't it? But there are limits. Wenton just taking a little breather this round.
And yet still winning it on my card. He's flawless at the moment, really.
Oh, you know, a good right hand from the champ. Wilson's brother Drew putting a brave face on it, but doesn't look that confident of his brother's chances, does he?
No, he's concerned, isn't he?
Hit something. Don't wait too long. You've got to get punched up quick.
When you put on the ropes,
roll in, side to side.
Go and run at him. Walk him.
Slide and roll in.
Seconds out, round 10.
And you certainly cannot fault the Scottish corner for trying to gee their man up. They're trying every trick in the book. They're bullying him, they're flattering him, they're persuading him, they're everything, every trick in the book. psychological and physical, to try and pull something out of this contest.
And I tell you, Wilson Docherty's fitness is unbelievable, really. He's taken a pounding for 10 rounds. Well, 9 rounds, I should say, and he's still coming forward and looking very, very lively.
And Tommy Gilmore and Drew Docherty just almost hurling themselves into the ring, trying to urge their man on. But he is, if there's one fall maybe, he has maybe accorded Wenton, either wittingly or unwittingly, a little too much respect in this contest. He's always been willing, in the event of the odd times there's been an accidental foul, to tap gloves, and maybe he's living a little bit too nice. Maybe he wants to see a little bit more spite, a little bit more fire from Docherty.
Well, Wenton is down to slow this run now. It's the first real signs of tiredness. He's not thrown much back.
Oh, well, great defence from Wenton.
Just boxing very well, isn't he?
Yeah, just body movement, making Docherty miss. That was lovely to watch. Pure class. Well, perhaps an early reminder, when we have our Pro Box Awards in July, this, I'm sure, will be a candidate for Fight of the Year. Maybe you might argue, and you may have a point, a little bit too one-sided, but I think you'll agree this has been an absolute masterly display of boxing by Wenton.
Well, yes, maybe there's a call for an award performance of the year, because this could surely win that. He's boxed perfectly tonight.
Well, inside the last 30 seconds of round 10. And I tell you, some contests can be a bit of a chore to commentate on. Sometimes they're an absolute pleasure. And this is one of those contests. Absolute joy to watch. And your heart really, as I've said before, really does go out to Docherty, who has never wavered, never let his head drop, and as the spirit this fight has been fought under. That's what I was telling you about.
Well, I'm going to actually give that round to Docherty. I think Wenton eased off the pedal a little bit too much in that round. Landed some good shots. Here we see Wenton rolling under the shots from Docherty. Docherty throws a 3 or 4 punch combination. Misses with every one.
Oh, that's just great. That is just great, that. Absolutely super.
Seconds out, round 11.
Well, I'm sure just 6 minutes now stand between Richie Wenton and a Lonsdale belt. If Docherty was a renowned puncher, well, you never know, it might be a different story, but that isn't the case. And really the only point of argument now is going to be the size of Wenton's victory margin on Richie Davis' scorecard. I'm sure the Scots will claim, and perhaps may even believe, that it's a lot closer than it actually is, but watching this from a purely neutral standpoint, Wenton on my card, and I'm sure on Nicky's card too, is going to be a pretty overwhelming winner. Just a slip.
Bit too much water in that corner.
And Docherty, Drew Docherty at ringside, just yelling at his brother, just go forward. And you can imagine how frustrating it must be for Drew Docherty and Tommy Gilmore. Absolutely impotent at ringside, nothing they can do except yell, and even then, Docherty himself so focused, he probably can't hear them. Do you hear things that the crowd, supporters in the crowd yell, Nicky, when you're fighting?
Very rarely, now and then you can pick the odd voice out, but very rarely. I don't know how Drew Docherty and Tommy Gilmore would relish being called impotent at ringside, Dave, but I get your meaning.
I hope they haven't got a VHS running at home. I hear from them in the morning.
Well, let's hope they can hear you. That's right.
Well, you heard that from Tommy. Back in again, Wilson. And, well, as I said a little earlier, if he's going to go down, he might as well give it a go, go down guns firing. And he's certainly trying absolutely 100%, Docherty, coming forward. What a bad round for him.
A little low, that right cross on the hip of Drew Docherty. Shot from Wenton. Getting a little bit untidy now. 11th round of a good pace fight, it's understandable. Good right hand again from Wenton. Catches Docherty with the counter over the lead.
And once again, the Scot trying to force the pace this round. And by no means a bad round for him. Remember when I've enjoyed a British title fight more. And in addition to the two boxers, we've got to say well done to Richie Davis as well. Well, it's got to be just safety first perhaps for Wenton in the final round. Just keep out of trouble, keep the left jab sticking out. It's home and dry.
Get the right hand away, the top edge left.
Docherty corner, of course, don't see it quite that way.
Both hands.
Well, he's worked very hard for this fight.
Seconds out, 12, and last round.
So out we come for the final round of what has been a superb British title fight. Richie Wenton, a masterclass in the art of boxing. Skill personified, the man in the white trunks. And a worthy opponent in Wilson Docherty, who was stuck in there, shown admirable reserves of courage and stamina, and at times no little skill. But tonight, as I'm sure when the adrenaline has subsided, I'm sure he will be the first to admit that he's given best to a really, really outstanding performance by Wenton.
Well, Docherty again through a little bit more this round again. Tremendous fitness.
Well, both boys toe-to-toe in the final round. Docherty's left eye almost closed now.
He's never stopped trying for the whole 12 rounds.
And he's got himself cut now on the left eye for his troubles. What a shame. In the final round, a little nick on the outside of Docherty's left eye. Oh, I told you the eye was looking a little bit suspect. Been proved right. Just a little nick, no more than quarter of an inch long.
Getting through some good shots now. Docherty forcing the pace. Well, I'm sure you'll see both men go to referee Richie Davis with an arm, expecting the result, but there's only one winner, isn't there, David? Sir Richie Wenton.
Yeah, absolutely. No arguments from me. Only argument will be how Richie Davis scores it. Outstanding contest, absolutely outstanding. No doubt. No doubt at all.
I've got 119, 116.
Well, I've got 119.5, 115.5. So there we go. We're much of a muchness, and well, I think he's quite pleased. He wants to marry him. There we go. Richie Wenton, still the super bantamweight champion of Great Britain, a Lonsdale belt outright. And we will, of course, be talking to Richie in a moment or so. Barry Hearn going over to congratulate him. And that really typifies the spirit in which this contest has been fought. That was absolutely memorable, and I go on record, credit to both boys, that was absolutely superb. I think Alan has got the result now up in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Richie Davis scores the contest 116.5 to Wilson Docherty, 118.5 to Richie Wenton, the winner and still the British Super Bantamweight champion, Richie Wenton.
Well, a little closer perhaps, Nicky, than either of us made it, but no doubts at all about the winner, and still a pretty overwhelming winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been a tremendous challenge from Wilson Docherty, a tremendous effort.
Well, what we're going to do now is we are going to let Richie Wenton get checked out by the doctor, Ozzie Ross. And when that formality has been concluded, join us back at ringside and we'll be hearing from the man who was still super bantamweight champion, Richie Wenton.
Ski scene.
This program is presented on Eurosport by Colmar Skiware.
Euroski, Wednesday at midday on Eurosport.
Richie Wenton, there is only one. He is still a champion. He's got a Lonsdale belt. I've never seen you box better, Richie.
No, well, to be honest with you, I underestimated the kid. I mean, all the newspapers were making him out to be an easy fight, you know, which was a joke. No fight's easy when you get to championship level. And, you know, even if it's against no good fighters. Every fight's a hard fight. You've trained months and months and months for the fight. But he put up a stiff and sterling show, you know.
How much did it take to come back from the European title defeat against Belcastro?
Well, to be honest with you, it took me 15 and a half hours to get over there, and I was mentally and physically drained by the time I got over there. Plus, obviously, referee, but I'm not going to make no excuses. The fight was that fight. If I had them in this country, I'm sure it'd be a different matter. Can I just say one thing? I'd say to someone who's in hospital, her name's Kim Nurse. She's had a major operation, and you know, she's a good friend of mine, and she, you know, she's sick. You know, I wish her to get better.
Well, we'll second that. There's if we can, if you watch the monitor over there, you'll see some action from round three. Talk us through that.
Well, I thought he was a weak fighter, but he's not. I started waiting to the body, and Ed, but he's a tough little nut like his brother, and he fought all the way. You know, I was hitting him with shots, but he come back after them. I wobbled him a few times, but he still come back, you know. I mean, I thought my best asset was my defence, but if you see the face on me now, it's spectacular, you know.
And the defence was great as well. I think we've got to give a lot of credit to the fella to your left in the red T-shirt, Glyn Rhodes as well.
Glyn Rhodes, top coach.
Glyn, talk us through this yourself.
Well, halfway through the fight, we realised that the guy was as strong as he was. So I said to Richie, don't try and knock the guy out, just give him a boxing lesson. Let him walk onto the shots. Like I said, we underestimated how strong the guy were. But luckily, Richie came out a winner.
Well, Richie, finally, you've got a Lonsdale belt outright. That, tell us what that means to you.
That means too much to me. It means everything to me, especially for the guy that died for it. You know, God bless him. You know what I mean? It really means that. I mean, I couldn't look at this belt before this fight. I could never look at it before any British title fight. I have to leave it in the briefcase. I've got it in, and I can't look at it, you know.
Richie, you proved a lot of things to a lot of people tonight. Well done. We'll leave you the champion. We'll take a short break. Join us with Georgie Smith in just a couple of moments here on Pro Box.
Country. He's 28 years old.
And he won 88 of his 109 fights. He was the European welterweight champion at just 17. And before he was 20, he had knocked out Bombardier Billy Wells.